here. Are you going to be in it or not?
Put in the corner.
Ready? We're at the Minneapolis Institute of Art. Been here before. Never when I was a kid and I lived here. It's pretty cool. It opens in a few minutes. We're just waiting. Want to come along? This is pretty. It's nice to go through rooms we've never been through before. It's huge. Oh, like I said, look at this. Isn't that beautiful? Yeah, that's me there. It's a maze. Find your way through this place. I've already headed up these stairs. Period rooms. Well, that's kind of cool. The Frankfurt kitchen, the old style kitchen. Ooh, I want a Frankfurt kitchen. The Frankfurt kitchen introduced concepts that still appeal to us today. It is efficient, space saving, and easy to clean. Prep while sitting on a stool, dry your dishes in the rack above the sink. Baking and cooking staples are kept handy in labeled aluminum bins. Unlike old-style kitchens with dirty wood-burning stoves, this kitchen has a modern electric stove, a large window for natural light, a movable ceiling light fixture, a pass-through to the dining room, and even a mounted ironing board. Counters were so low so that you could sit and look at the counters rather than standing. They're still too low for that. The curator's office. It's your long-lost uncle. Who is it?
You might have to do it from over here so that she's their face. It had it on the... Oh! And you just tap the screen.
Oh.
Or not, you have to tap the bubble, I guess.
Let me see. That's cool. This guy's missing some body parts. Look! It's a ballerina. A Degas. How do you say it? Degas? Degas? I cannot remember. I love art that's spotted like this. Can you tell? I don't know if you can tell on that one. It's like little tiny dots that all come together. And I don't think I could ever paint like that. Where'd she go? Looks just like the one in Washington, D.C. and the other place, too. Oh, olive trees, so it's a little different. Bye, Vincent Van. Go. Where'd she go? In that room. I want to go track her down. Here's another haystack. That just tells you it's Claude Monet. Okay, green stack. Sun in the mist. How many people do you know come to a museum to look at the frames? He's here looking at the frames.
Probably a picture.
Yeah. That's nice. The frame and the painting.
This is where you can see that it's real gold.
Oh, how?
See how the gold leaf pieces overlap?
Yes.
Either that or they made it look like it.
Why will only
Chinese,
real gold do that?
No, the Chinese, they put lines on their fake gold paintings or frames.
Right.
To make it look like it's gold leaf. But that's what you get when you do your gold leaf that overlaps. Yeah, I wouldn't mind having that one. That's nice.
Yeah. Kind of looks like her head's on backwards.
I'd even go for a French guy like Villard.
See, doesn't it? that's just me. I think it looks like her head's on backwards.
Yeah, I'm trying to see the difference in gold frames and painted frames. And
right, because you're looking at repairing old frames.
And here you can see some lines in it, but I'm not sure if those are from doing gold leaf or not.
I don't see them. And I don't think the camera will pick it up.
Yeah, you can see them. There's a line there.
It just looks like it's dirty, but now that you say that.
Yeah, those are the finished sheets of gold.
I'm so impressed with the detail. It almost looks like a photo. Doesn't it? It looks like a photo. I won't even try to say his name. Jean-Léon Giron? French. I did take French in school, but what is this? Oh boy. Okay.
You
better
get it.
I'm trying. Okay, wait a minute. Look at that. We almost lost touch, but I can see his reflection in that mirror. Super cool. Fiona, Veiled Lady. How do you carve that marble? It truly looks like she's got a veil over her face. Does it? Jackie needs to paint this for me.
23 karat gold.
Yeah, he needs to paint this one for me. I'll tell you who made it. Another frame. So show me the lines.
The lines right here show where the leaves.
The gold leaf, so that's real gold leaf on it.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
And then where it rubs off, if they painted it red before.
Before they put the
100 bases red.
Ah.
And then it rubs off, then the red shows through.
Okay, why red and not black or something? That one's really bright. A study in still life? Hands? Fruit? What do you think their focus was? The hands? Are different in proportion. This side, their fingers are long and skinny. And this side, they are not. John Wilde. Peeling, it's called. Imagine that. Your detail was way too short. Way too short. We've been here just half an hour or so, but we have to go. To go to. This is a neat museum. I could stay here a lot longer. There's so much to see. Another marble. I gotta show you this one. Look at this. It's either a huge eagle or a tiny person. Time and effort goes into it. I just can't imagine hours spent. And what if you make a mistake? You can't cover it up or glue it back on. Wow. Okay, now show me.
Leave it up.
It's not defacing art. It's creating art. It's creating art. I don't like that. Sorry, William Hogarth. Hogarth. So cool. Oh, and this is something I have to show you. The Minneapolis. Downtown Minneapolis skyline. On a cloudy day. I'll try this one because his face is kind of looks like a real face.
Well, if I got it that easy on this one, maybe I can flip it and get both of us.
That's annoying. Did it work?
Yeah.
Let me see.
Do you want to be in it?
Sure, we could try.
Oh, wow. Look at that.
And watch us. Wow. Okay, I don't care for these so much. Saint Catherine. Oh, it's wood. Maybe that's why I don't care for it so much. Stalled, but we ran out of time. Now we're leaving. If you ever make it to Minneapolis, it's a free museum. Definitely check it out.